Now, if a fusion had occurred, what would we expect to see? There should be telltale signs of that. So you see these little dark blue caps on the ends of the chromosomes. Those are called telomeres. They're certain sequences of DNA. It kind of repeats itself over and over again. They serve as end caps to kind of protect the DNA. And interestingly enough, one of their jobs is to prevent fusion. So I'm kind of struggling how they were involved in a fusion when that's one of their jobs is to prevent it. So we should see a bunch of telomere sequences right there. The other thing is this little red symbolic square here, that's a centromere. Every chromosome has one centromere, and it's important when the cells are dividing and the DNA material needs to be divided up between the two cells. There are certain sequences associated with those. So we should see one in the fused chromosome. It's not active anymore, but it should be there along with the real one. So that's what we should see. So we can sequence human chromosome 2, and we can look for those things. And that's what they've done. And so what did they find? Well, they're having trouble finding a lot of those telomeres in the middle. There's some sequences there that are sort of kind of like telomeres, but not nearly in the number they should be, okay, if they're truly telomeres. So that's a problem, okay? The telomere sequences, even the evolutionists would admit that it's very, very degenerate, and they kind of scratch their heads like, well, why is it so degenerate? Why aren't there more telomere sequences here? Because it's not a fusion. that's why. There shouldn't be any telomeres there because it's not two chromosomes that have fused together. Then they looked for that centromere, that other centromere that should be there, and they can't really find it. There's some sequences there that sometimes are associated with centromeres, but they're certainly not unique to centromeres. We find them in other places. So that's a problem as well. That other inactivated centromere isn't there. Now, there's many other lines of evidence that Dr. Tompkins has developed to show that it just doesn't look like a fused chromosome. It doesn't match up with chromosomes 12 and 13. And one of them that he found, and he's published on this, and you'll see the reference in the next slide, is he found a gene there, okay, that spans the fusion site. Genes are always found on just one chromosome. I mean, it's not part of the genes here on this chromosome and part of the genes over here on this chromosome, okay? That doesn't happen. The gene's always on the one on one chromosome. So how could it be that you somehow had parts of it on both and then they fused together and now those parts are together? That's just not realistic. So here's the supposed fusion site and here's the gene, right? Part of it's on one side and part of it's on the other side. The other thing is telomeres don't occur in the middle of genes. I mean, genes aren't around telomeres. So it's just filled with a lot of problems. And the conclusion is that human chromosome 2 is not the result of a fusion. It just doesn't match up sequence-wise with chimp chromosomes 12 and 13. So therefore, it cannot support common ancestry for humans and chimps.